हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रीतेश पाटिल फ्रॉम AISSMS IOIT डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डेटाबेस आर्किटेक्चर। सो डेटाबेस आर्किटेक्चर एक्चुअली ब्रॉडली इट इज कैटेगराइज्ड इनटू फोर कैटेगरीज। दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज सेंट्रलाइज्ड क्लाइंट सर्वर पैरेलल एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड। बट इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू सी ओनली सेंट्रलाइज्ड एंड क्लाइंट सर्वर बेस्ड डेटाबेस आर्किटेक्चर्स। So the multi-user database system architecture, actually if we consider this multi-user database system architecture, so we'll come across the centralized DBMS. So centralized DBMS is nothing but is running with a mainframe computer which is having the database management system functionality. There are certain application programs running onto it, and there are some user interfaces which will help the users to put the connection between database and their application. And for this, the hardware which is required is the computer terminal, which is running with the input and output devices, and that belongs to the centralized DBMS. And then comes the client-server computer architecture. Actually, it is influenced by the underlying computer technology, basically the networking technology, and the usage of database in terms of the networking. That is the main point of attraction for the client server computer architecture. So the terminals, the PCs are replaced with the PCs and workstations. Mainframe computers, computer is replaced by specialized server that we call it as a blade server or database server. So there are so many servers which are available, that is file server, DBMS server, mail server, print server, etc. All these servers are connected in network with the clients. Client at any location can give the request to any of the server. For example, this client one demands any file from this file server can do it. Like this client two, if he want to release the print, so print server can be accessed, likewise the database server. If any user is trying to retrieve certain specific record from this DBMS, and the request will be given to the DBMS server and it will respond accordingly. And then this is the schematic of the multi-user database system architecture, where you will find various clients on different sites. So sites are cited here as site 1, 2 up to n. Each site is running with certain limitations. Like site 1 is having only the system but not the storage, which is denoted in green. The site 2 is having only the storage capacity, but site 3 is having a server and the storage capacity. Site n is having client as well as the server with database, the storage capacity, and all these sites are connected with a communication network. So client server database architecture, if you see as a broad, so it consists of database client. This client are clients are running with a user interface, application programs. This user interface is nothing but the application program interface, where the users can develop their own applications and provide some interfacing with the internal features. So next part of client server database architecture is the database server. Database server is running with the specialized SQL language and transaction management. So all the requests made by the client will be provided to the database server, and database server SQL evaluation engine will evaluate those queries and perform the transaction. And lastly, the database connection, and that is the open database connectivity ODBC, and the application program interface, that is achieved by the database connections. So thank you very much.